Bueno, mi gente, saludos, bienvenidos a esta interesante entrevista con una superestrella de la música global. Yo realmente no sé cómo vamos a ir bregando la entrevista porque yo no sé mucho inglés, tanto cuarto que mi mamá invirtió cuando yo era carajito, pero no pude. Pero vamos a ver cómo le damos. Vamos a darle la bienvenida acá a Super Q 100.9, Conexión Urbana, Cachicha. Lo más importante que hay en la red, a la superestrella Akon in the building. What's up, bro?
What's up, big man?
¿Cómo te sientes?
How you feel?
Bien.
¿Te sientes bien?
Muy bien.
Yeah. Tú sabes que Akon es uno de los pocos artistas que siempre ha tenido en su radar el mercado latino.
Well, mainly because I love Latin music. And another reason is because I'm African.
Yeah.
When you look at Africans and Latins, it's like we share the same culture with one. Even in history, our roots all come back to one another. So the energy here is just so, it's home for me, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hace mucho tiempo, por ejemplo, tú tuviste algo que ver con Zion en su momento, Zion,
no,
baby.
Yeah, I know you saw something with Zion.
Yeah. So, Al sol de hoy en día es que vemos un poquito que el mercado americano le da la apertura a los artistas latinos como Bad Bunny, Anuel, entre otros.
No, I love that. I think this should have happened a lot sooner.
Yeah.
You know, even back when I was doing remixes for my first album, with Locked Up, my first remix was Bote. Even then, I made an attempt to open the door for us to market and come together. Then I did the I Wanna Love You with, you know, with Don Omar.
Yeah.
You know, and then after that's when, but it was Zion that gave me the idea of doing collaborations on that level because he was the first that I did an official, you know, song that was half English, half Spanish in one record.
¿Qué le falta al mercado latino para poder como afianzarse más como el mercado anglosajón?
I think actually Latin music is doing it. You know, right now, Latin music is very respected in the business. They doing numbers far greater than Americans. I think the only thing that could be better is more exposure to Dominican music because the culture is a lot more deeper. I think the only thing that's left is for Dominican artists to come together and collaborate and help each other the same way that Puerto Rican artists are doing.
Right. ¿Cómo te interesas por el mercado dominicano? ¿Estás haciendo una colaboraciones bien interesantes con artistas locales, musicólogos, The Book, Yao, Melly Mel?
Oh man, they the streets to me, you know? And they started from the bottom. Like,
yeah.
That's something I can relate to. Like, I felt like working with artists that struggle, the music is more passionate and it means more.
Omega El Fuerte.
Yeah.
Un artista que siempre ha estado en tu radar toda la vida. De hecho, la canción, el producto es Beck. Beck, son. ¿Cuál es tu consejo para Omega? Para que Omega pueda tener la dimensión que un artista de su categoría debe tenerla.
Well, first of all, let me say I love Omega like my brother. You know, he's like family to me.
Yeah.
And I always looked at Dominican as a whole through the eyes of Omega because he's a product of his environment. And I feel like if Dominican Republic created more opportunities for artists, people like Omega wouldn't be in that position because he would advance beyond Dominican Republic. So if we can make or change the mistake that the system made by not giving those opportunities to people like Omega, then perhaps maybe the way we're doing it now may give that opportunity so people don't end up in those situations like Omega.
Okay. Vienes de la calle, probaste la cárcel. Sabes lo que significa estar debajo. Has podido hacer grandes negocios, has podido ser ejemplo filántropo también, you know. So esos chamaquitos que nos están viendo ahora, que están también haciendo sus diligencias como hacemos aquí o decimos aquí haciendo dili. So, ¿qué tú le puedes decir para que ellos puedan tirar para adelante y cumplir su sueño?
Well, the best thing I can tell them it's the first focus on what it is you want to do, because you have to have a focus. You have to have a clear roadmap to where you want to go. And then from there, you have to create a plan. With that plan comes the patience, because everything is not going to happen overnight. You slowly, you know, work towards that plan until you get to the goal. Once you get to the goal, everything in the world is going to open up for you.
La experiencia que te hizo recapacitar y te puso a escribir los éxitos que hoy en día nosotros conocemos, ¿qué te hizo sentar cabeza y cambiar tu rumbo?
Well,
the big question.
That's the big question.
Yeah.
Because listen, before the music, I was like everybody else in the barrio.
Yeah.
So, when I got, see, before I went in, I had a habit of writing songs and poetry because I didn't really want to talk to people about it. So what ends up happening is every experience I wrote songs about it. So when I got locked up, I naturally wrote about being locked up. So it was that habit that actually saved me, because by accident I became a musician. Because when I got out of jail, I didn't want to go back into the same environment that got me in there. So ultimately that became the things that I created that gave me the opportunity to become who I am today.
Seguimos conversando con la superestrella de la música, Akon, que está en Solo Dominicano y está haciendo música para llevar el talento dominicano a otras aguas. Y obviamente tiene que pasar por acá, por Conexión Urbana 100.9 Super Cuca Chicha. Si tienes la oportunidad de armar un team de rapero de todos los tiempos, ¿cuál es tu equipo?
Bro, it's so many. It's too many.
Es demasiado, dice. Es demasiado.
Yeah. Five.
Okay. I would probably... Is Omega considered a rapper?
No, Mambo.
Okay. So, it would be Musical Logo, Lapis, what's the one with the El Guitar?
Shallow Jack.
Whoa.
I like Shallow Jack.
The guy from yesterday.
Yeah, I like Shallow Jack. Mark B. Is he rapper or singer?
He's a singer.
Okay.
Yeah, single, Mark B.
What's the guy, the crazy guy?
Kiko called Crazy.
Jerry.
I love Jerry's Khan.
I like Jerry.
Why?
Too. Huh?
Por qué?
He just, the personality. Like, he makes me happy.
Okay.
Yeah, he makes me happy. And then we can't forget Melly Mel. To me, she's a dope.
No puede perder a Melly Mel. No le puede olvidar a Melly Mel.
But it's too many more. I feel bad.
Okay, este es el inicio de algo bueno que viene para el movimiento urbano dominicano. ¿Cuáles son los planes de Akon, además de, por ejemplo, hacer la canción con Musicólogo, con Marvin, todo? ¿Cuáles son los planes de ahora en adelante?
Well, the next plan, which we just started, we activated Convict Culture, which is the convict culture here in Dominica. Yep. And my goal is to sign all the hottest Dominican Republic artists.
Okay.
And we're going to take over Latin music.
Yeah. I like. So, ¿de dónde viene el nombre Convict Music?
So, Convict Music was the beginning. But music now is no longer just music. Now it's a culture. Because it's a lifestyle now.
Okay, una cultura, right.
Por eso ya cambió por Convict Culture.
Right. Convict, o sea, convicto, you know.
Right.
For West coming convict.
Well, it started with me being locked up first, right? Then I realized it's bigger than me being locked up. It's the mind states of our minds and our mentality.
Yeah.
So you don't have to be in jail to be locked up. So the music of Convict is based and it represents the struggles of the people and the area in which they come from that they need to get out of.
República Dominicana, ¿qué más países estás buscando artistas para entrarlo a la cultura?
I didn't think that far, because I've been everywhere in the world. But Dominican right now is my main focus, because I really want to give them a fair shot to become the stars that they deserve.
Okay. República Dominicana, ¿por qué?
Because the struggle is real here.
Hey.
And there has to be opportunities that's created. Otherwise, Dominican Republic won't be no different from Venezuela.
Okay, seguimos acá con Aikon. Recuerden suscribirse. Aquí está arroba Conexión Urbana. Nosotros estamos aquí hablando con Aikon de los proyectos que vienen. República Dominicana, un epicentro importante de la música ahora. Aikon, tú en el momento que estuviste creativo, Lady Gaga estuvo también en tu disquera, ¿verdad? Entonces, ¿seguirás también haciendo cosas en el mercado anglosajón o te vas a enfocar por el momento en nosotros acá, latinos, mientras tanto?
Where my translator go? What happened? What you doing?
Yeah, Omega, yeah, throw me up, Omega.
Let them deal with that. Babsy's dealing with that. You gotta translate, Alpha. Okay, sorry. otra.
Está cabrón. Okay.
Dale, conseguimos aquí.
Sí.
Yo en Instagram.
Okay. Wow. Está cabrón, Ralphie. Okay. Dame un break. Okay, seguimos acá con la super mega estrella de la música, Aikon. Te preguntaba, artistas como Lady Gaga, que pertenecen a tu sello, son super grandes. ¿Tú tienes alguna visión de otro artista que pueda llegar a esa dimensión?
Oh yeah, 100%. We have a new artist that we're about to branch in a few. She's coming very soon. Her name is Alex.
Latinos, aparte de obviamente Bad Bunny, Anuel, Ozuna, ¿a quién ves con ese potencial?
Oof, sheesh. That's actually a very good question.
The best.
Es una muy buena pregunta.
Well, I mean, it actually depends on the audience, because that's not something that you can predict, because every artist is different, and every artist has his habits, goods and bads, but whichever one of them can stay consistent, if they can stay consistent, they will take it to the top.
Ya para ir finalizando, ¿cuál es la canción más grande de Aikon desde tu punto de vista?
My biggest hit was Mr. Lonely.
Yeah. I wanna love you.
Yeah, man. I wanna love you was big too. Yeah. I wanna love you was big.
Smack Dag
was big. But when you look at the numbers, Mr. Lonely broke the Guinness Book of World Records.
A propósito, ahora mismo está de moda hacer remezclas de super éxitos. ¿Te atreverías tú a hacer una remezcla con artistas del momento ahora a Lonely?
For Mr. Lonely?
Yeah,
if I had to choose an artist for Mr. Lonely, I'd probably choose.
Hey! Yeah!
I would do a bachata version with Romero de Santos.
Whoa!
I think that would be crazy.
Yeah. Consejo para todo el artista que está ahora mismo viendo el show.
Oh man, all I can tell you is thank you very much. You know, the love, the welcome, the hospitality. I mean, I feel at home here, man. So all the support is very, very well welcomed and appreciated.
Última pregunta. ¿Conoces la música del Nene La Amenaza?
I may know it. I just have to hear it because sometimes I know the song but don't know the artist that's singing.
I'm bad with it.
Right. Alfa, el jefe.
You know Alfa?
I know the name Alfa for sure. That's what I'm saying. I can't put the name and the music together.
Right.
I know all the songs, but sometimes I don't know which is the artist.
Does that make sense?
Gracias, bro. Gracias. Yeah.